Genomic studies have mostly focused on European ancestry and neglected ethnic minorities for decades, experts say. But now, projects aimed at bridging the diversity gap are on the rise.
The Genome Asia 100K project was set up in 2016 by company MedGenome and Singapore's Nanyang Technological University. Based at the university's Centre for Life Science Engineering, or CELSE, Genome Asia 100K aims to sequence 100,000 genomes to create a genetic representation of Asian human variation. I caught up with the project's scientific director, Stefan Schuster.
The project clearly has two parts. So step one is to understand the genetic makeup of Asians as a whole entity. But then the second one is to find out which of those genetic markers that we newly discover are actually ethical markers and are not disease markers as they have been described in the genomes of European descendants.
Can you give us a sense of the samples and the individual populations that you're targeting here?
As in many instances, we are standing on the shoulders of generation of scientists before us, and many of them have been Japanese anthropologists that were traveling the world for decades, and they have created a collection of samples. Eventually, the keepers of the samples realized that the samples would degrade, and then the decision was made on why not to convert those existing samples into digital information.
And is that a portion of the 100,000 samples?
It was the building blocks that kicked off the project.
Thanks to the contributions from national collections, donors, clinicians, and scientists, the project has built on from those original samples. Both sampling and data analysis take place in the project's two labs at the university. Here, scientists are extracting DNA from human tissue and chemically preparing it. This process is called library construction, and it's achieved alongside use of robotics. Once the DNA is prepared, it's taken to another lab where it's loaded into a sequencer that reads the data and translates it into digital information. Each single sequencing round takes around 3 days. In a week, the machine can produce around 80 human genomes. Healy Kim is the project's lead researcher.
How cutting edge is this technology?
So the first is the speed of the machine can sequence the DNA. The second is the speed of the process, the big amount of the data at the same time in the huge computing resources. Without the technology, we cannot handle this big data.
The robotics and the automation, absolutely crucial here. Are you guys looking at leveraging AI in all of this?
The AI can help for the identification of the variation, plus it also helps to annotate the function of those variations.
Genome Asia 100K still has a way to go before reaching its goal. So far, it's sequenced around 10,000 genomes from 25,000 samples spanning 450 Asian ethnicities.
Can you give us some of the key insights that the project has already gained?
The first and most stunning lesson was that we never expected genetic diversity of Asians to be so deep. And the second insight is that this is the most important time to collect, describe, and work with indigenous groups, and also make the world understand how important the contributions from these groups are that are really living at the brink of extinctions right now. This is the key mission of the project. It will help to separate disease alleles from ethnic alleles.
A disease allele is a genetic variation that might contribute to a medical condition. Related data can help scientists understand how susceptible a certain community could be to a specific disease.
The big advance that comes from what is called the next generation sequencing that allows to generate these masses of data is that we have entered the area of personalized medicine. The idea is you would sequence the genome of a patient and you will be able to tailor-made a treatment, medication for that person. We try to build on that concept, and our key paradigm is how can precision medicine be precise if you don't precisely know who you are?
And in very simple terms, what is the medical relevance here?
When we develop pharmaceuticals, it's in the analogy of you only produce one t-shirt. It's white, it's XL, and everybody has to wear it. And what we are trying to say is the pharmaceutical industry also needs to look at the other sizes, and they need to make sure that the drugs that they develop are compatible. And the factor of ethnicity is currently not represented in precision medicine.
Diversity in genomic research is crucial for ensuring medicine works for all. By expanding data sets, we unlock the stories of the past and increase medical opportunities for future generations.